Hey guys!
Alright guys, we're here today to check out a Patreon request from this patron right here. Ask us to check out Hellripper, All Hail the Goat. Alright, so first I want to say that Hellripper reminds me of the show The 100, because there's a girl there, she's a badass. And she was known in one of the seasons as Skyripper, because she killed everybody. So, and she was from Sky Crew. Don't ask me. If you don't watch the show, you don't have no clue what I'm talking about. But anyways, they call her Sky Ripper. So Hell Ripper reminds me a little bit of that. By the way, that show is really weird. So apparently in the post-apocalyptic world, after the world gets nuked left, right, and center, everybody has a Jamaican accent. Well, not everybody, but most people have a Jamaican accent. Because in that show, there's a thing called Prime Fire. And they don't say Prime Fire. They say Prime Fire. Like, I'm like, what the hell? Like,
have you ever...
And I don't think they're in Jamaica, by the way.
Oh, I was gonna say, have you ever, you know, thought that the show was based in a post-apocalyptic
Jamaica? No, I think they're in North America.
I mean, that would be the funniest place also
to have like a post-apocalyptic show in Jamaica. Oh, that would be hilarious. Imagine a bunch of Rastafarians like after I don't think they would care. They would be just like smoking doobies and whatever. It's like, who cares? All right, I don't think this has anything to do with that, by the way, because the All Hail the Goat sounds like some black metal.
Yeah.
And I think it is. All right. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do this. On Patreon discover these bands? Like, that's the first question I have. The second question is, since when did Motorhead do black metal?
I was gonna say that.
Like, seriously, like,
I was like just expecting I was only expecting like
from pure,
the,
like...
From the deepest, darkest, like, caverns of hell? Norway.
Oh, of Norway. Okay, that's close to hell anyways. From a musical perspective. Yeah.
For some black metal. And then it just started, I'm like, why does this just sound like black metal Motorhead? Like, and also, it didn't sound, the track didn't sound like overproduced, like clean. Mm. It sounded like something you would get like from back in the day.
But it has that black, pure rock and roll. I'm trying to word my sentence properly. So I think what I want to say is this. When you think of black, like when you look at really black metal, is nothing more than pure like rock and roll, just with an edge.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It's like it's like rock and roll turned to 2:11. You know what I mean? So the rawness that the track has fits both the pure like rock and roll side of the track, but it also fits the black metal side of the track. It almost that unpolished sound that you were talking about to me is a huge factor. Like when you think of Motorhead, when you think of even looking at black metal bands, to me that unpolished sound, it's a huge it's the aroma,
especially black metal, where black metal bands like to have their sound be like that crunchy like unfiltered sound.
Like an overproduced,
yeah,
like really like almost straight out of a jam session.
Exactly.
But to me that's part of the aroma, you know.
It's part of the genre.
Yeah, it's part of the allure that music has within itself. You take that away, you overproduce it, and then it's not black metal anymore. It could be symphonic black metal. It could be another variation of black metal, but melodic not, black metal, whatever. But it's, whatever.
True,
but it's not, you know, like the purest form of black metal. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, to me, that rawness is needed there. This track was magnificent, by the way. Absolutely magnificent. I loved it. I honestly don't know where you folks on Patreon discover, like, Hellripper. Like where you, like... Like, where you discover these bands? Like, seriously. I mean, we discover them thanks to you guys, but where do you find these bands?
I feel like they just...
Maybe Spotify.
I don't know. Oh, maybe Spotify. Or they just go and they search up, like...
A specific genre?
Yeah, and then they go through each band.
And then they discover some gems here and there. Wow. This is definitely
that
a gem.
That takes dedication.
It does. But this is, like... The mixture of those two sounds...
It's perfect.
Yeah, it's absolutely perfect. I love this track. Like, the first, and the other thing is the chorus is very rock and roll. It's very, very
the whole song.
The whole song is very rock and roll. But the chorus with the "All Hail the Goat," like it just has this catchiness to it. Like, yeah. I was singing along. Like, by the time the second chorus came around, I was already singing along. It's so easy to remember. Wow, loved it. I love the simplicity that the track has too. It's not complicated. Yeah. It's very simple. The structure of the song is simple. Everything about the song is simple, but it works. I like it. All right, that was a great request from Patreon. All right, guys, thank you to the person who requested the song. I really want to say that because this was a gem.
Yeah.
All right, guys, come back tomorrow. We'll have more tracks to discover with all of you. All right, see you tomorrow.
See ya.